Well, good morning, Jebediah. How's it hanging?
Not too good.
Well, flibbity-jibbit-jeb, what seems to be the problem?
It's Gertrude.
Ah, Mrs. Greenfield, I'm on pins and needles. The anticipation is pure torture. Oh, I can't wait. I can't wait. Let me have it.
She's a bitch.
Mr. Greenfield, Gertrude is a muffin-making, pie-baking, blue-ribbon, squash-growing, God-fearing saint of a woman.
Well, yeah, she's good in the sack.
Holy effing snickerdoodles, big guy. May I remind you that I'm somewhere between 6 and 8.5 years old. Let's keep this conversation just under PG, shall we? Thanks.
Why am I talking to you?
Because I have a roadside stand and you can pay the bill with weed.
Oh, yeah.
Super. Now let's get back to the always effervescent Mrs. Greenfield.
She got into the cider.
Oh my god, I just love cider. Was it fresh or was it really old?
About 10 years old.
And approximately how much of this fermented beverage did she consume?
About a gallon.
Was she happy?
Yep.
Frisky?
Yep.
Doesn't sound like a problem.
Wasn't till I went down on her.
What happened?
She farted.
Disgusting. You'll get over it.
Not likely.
Oh, please. It could have been much worse.
It was.
Mm-hmm.
You see, it was dark and,
Yes?
I was looking around with my lighter.
No. I can see why you're all cattywampused. It's a classic case of confronting several primal fears simultaneously. Fear of separation, humiliation, fire, dealing with the overwhelming emotion of loss. Your face is obviously healed, but the scar shall remain forever embedded in your subconscious. The post-traumatic stress associated with any future random flatulence. It's all pretty much just boilerplate psychology. There's just one thing I don't really understand, if you might be so good as to elaborate for me.
What's that?
What exactly do you mean when you say, going down on her?